I'm going to call this meeting to order, just 2 minutes. It says right there, 6 o'clock. Person in charge says we still have 2 minutes, so go ahead and talk for another minute and a half. Person in charge says I can now start. Just a reminder that this meeting is being video recorded and streamed live on the internet. Madam Clerk, will you please confirm posting and roll call?
Mayor Pro Tem, this meeting has been posted in accordance with Nevada Open Meeting Law. All members of the council, with the exception of Mayor March, are present, and you have a quorum.
Thank you. I'd like to invite Lonnie Robbins, the first counselor in the Henderson, Nevada Lake Mead Stake of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, to the podium to give the invocation. Following the invocation, the Pledge of Allegiance will be led by retired United States Army Colonel Harold Wilson.
Our dear Father in heaven, we humbly bow before thee and give thanks unto thee for being able to be here this evening. We are so grateful for the many blessings which thou affords us, for being able to live in this wonderful country and in this wonderful city. We ask thee to please bless, continue to bless the city managers, those who are elected and those who are appointed, that they will continue to make wise decisions, that they will be led by thee. We ask thee to please bless us with thy spirit as we meet today. We are grateful for all that thou hast blessed us with. And we say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please face the United States flag. Put your hand over your heart. If you're a retired military or former military, you may salute. Please say with me, I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much. Mr. Derrick, are there any changes to the agenda?
I do have a few changes, Your Honor. UB23 is a continued zone change amendment and tentative map amendment for Montelago Village for Aventine Gardens and the accompanying bill, which is B37. We've had a request to withdraw without prejudice by the applicant. However, staff is recommending a 30-day continuance to your February 18th, 2020 meeting. NB27's appeal of a breeder permit revocation for Scott Burns. We've had a request to continue into the February 4th, 2020 City Council meeting at the request of Council. And B41, which is a First Amendment to Canyons at McDonald Ranch Park Agreement, has been withdrawn at the request of staff. And those are the changes I have for you, Your Honor.
Thank you. So I'll entertain a motion for approval of the agenda, noting the continuance of item 23. There's a motion. If you'll please vote. That motion carries.
First section of agenda is proclamations, commendations, and presentations. PR1 is a commendation for Liberty High School football team. I'd like to invite Coach Morocco to join the Mayor Pro Tem and Council at the podium to accept a commendation recognizing the players, coaches, staff, and leadership of the Liberty High School football team.
Yeah.
Liberty High School opened in 2003 to serve the rapidly growing area of West Henderson and the southeast area of Clark County. The Liberty Patriots football team has won several Sunrise Regional and Division championships during Coach Morocco's 10 years as head football coach. 2019 marked a banner season in which the Patriots stopped a 10-year Nevada State title streak for Bishop Gorman. In a 30-24 overtime Desert Region Championship win, on December 7, 2019, the Patriots toppled Centennial with a 50-7 victory for their first state championship. In recognition of their premier achievements, the Mayor Pro Tem and Council wish to present a commendation to Coach Rich Morocco and the 2019 Liberty Patriots football state champions.
Well, Coach, this is something to be proud of.
Absolutely.
Actually, I thought this was your contract extension. Congratulations. This is quite an honor, and you did a great job. These young men did an incredible job. Young men, stand up, all of you. Okay, give them a hand. Okay, sit down. Okay, where's all the parents? Stand up, stand up. All right. Okay. Cheerleaders. Cheerleaders. Flag twirlers. Who, what?
We got our
who's managers here? Managers. Managers. Stand up. All right. This is a team effort. Takes everybody.
Absolutely.
So we appreciate you as a city. You've brought a lot of fame and we hope fortune to the city of Henderson. So thank you very much. You guys are outstanding. We really appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
So you can say a few words.
First off, you know, it's not just myself, my coaching staff. If you guys could stand up, everybody that's here. Our outstanding administration led by Mr. Bello, you know, he supports our football program. He's the best principal in the school district. And obviously, it's all about the players. Without the players, it doesn't matter how great a coach you are. The players have to go out there and execute. And you guys did a fantastic job, and congratulations.
Thank you. Let's move this way.
Your next item is PR2, a proclamation for National Radon Action Month. I'd like to invite Director Susan Howe and Nadia Noel, Radon Education Coordinator for the Nevada Radon Education Program, to join the Mayor Pro Tem and Council at the podium to accept the proclamation for National Radon Action Month. The Nevada Radon Education Program is an initiative of the University of Nevada Cooperative Extension, charged with educating the citizens of Nevada about the potential health risks associated with this colorless, odorless, radioactive gas. The Mayor Pro Tem and Council wish to proclaim the month of January 2020 as National Radon Action Month and encourage residents to test their homes for radon.
There's some big kids there.
Good job, guys.
Good job. As many of you know, for the last several years, we've allocated time for radon prevent. We don't prevent it, but we awareness to make everyone aware of that. The City of Henderson provides free radon testing kits to those who would like them, and we support the state's actions in everything that they do to help alleviate this issue. So we want to present you with this proclamation. We're going to give you the microphone and let you tell us all about it. How's that?
Okay. Do you want to read that? Okay.
You can tell us anything you want to tell us about.
Well, thank you for this opportunity to come forward and present information about radon and National Radon Action Month. This is actually the fifth year that you have given us a proclamation, and we appreciate your support of our outreach efforts. And every home needs tested for radon, not just in Henderson, but everywhere. But we really appreciate you providing an easy location for Henderson residents. And just a matter of information, about 50% of the test kits that have been given out in Henderson have been used. And that equals about 1,400 valid test results that we've gotten. 78 happened last year. And Nadia's going to give some more.
So we're hosting radon presentations throughout the county in the next week or so. There are two coming up in Henderson, and the first is going to be at James Gibson Library on Friday at 10:30 a.m. and the second will be at Paso Verde Library next Monday at 6 p.m. There are many locations to pick up radon test kits, so let's say you have friends or family who live outside of Henderson. They can stop by the Extension office in Clark County in Las Vegas, or the one in Logandale, or Moapper Valley, or Mesquite. If individuals want more information on radon, they can visit our website, which is www.radonnv.com, or call our hotline, which is 888-RADON-10. And you can also find us on social media. On Facebook, we're Radon, or Nevada Radon Education, and then on Twitter, we are NV Radon Program. And then lastly, thank you for listening to our little speech, and you're going to be hearing the proclamation next, which will be great. And we appreciate your support of our work.
Thank you. Okay. Good morning.
Go ahead. So if you're not going to read this, I just want to let people know why to even be concerned about radon. Because radon can get into homes and cause lung cancer over time. So that's the health risk that we're concerned about.
Okay. All right.
Oh. We have some test kits here too, but they also have them at City Hall, but we have some tonight.
Right. Okay. We're going to take some photos.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Thank you. Thanks.
Next item on agenda is a PR3 presentation, Henderson Historical Society update. Mayor Pro Tem and Council, next on the agenda is a presentation by board members Sean DeFrank and Rick Watson from the Henderson Historical Society. Guided by a governing body of 10 volunteer board members, and other volunteers, the Society seeks to engage a diverse audience and present collections, stories, and programs about Henderson in ways that reflect honesty and integrity with the commitment to the fundamental goal that public knowledge of our city's past is the key to our future. Tonight's presentation will include an update on the souvenir license plate, Nevada license plates, the Henderson Speaks series, and other Henderson Historical Society outreach efforts. Welcome.
Mayor Pro Tem, members of the council, members of city government, and all of our guests. I think many of them left, but I'm Rick Watson, and I'm a member of the Henderson Historical Society. John DeFrank, also a member, and these ladies right here in the front row, Lynn Starr, Danelle Butler Hahn, Mary Monahan George, and Valerie Laporta Haynes. While back, the city and some of its different organizations tried to talk Lou Laporta into writing a book about Henderson, and he just didn't want to do it. You know, you get up there in years, that's a daunting task. He had another idea. The town he came from in New York had a really good historical society, and so instead of writing a book, he organized a historical society, which I think really is a harder task, you know, because it takes money. You write a book and they pay you. You start a historical society and you pay them. But anyway, Lou came here in 1945, and so he was just the right person. He knew, he got a chance to meet the founders of the town. And of course, he was really a founder himself. He was one of the first members of Henderson's first city council, and served throughout Clark County admirably over the years and continues here. I think he's 94, just turned 94 on the 18th, and still going strong and still has a great sense of community. Never has given up on his obligation or a sense of obligation to his town. So I'm gonna read some comments. I talk slow, and you'd never get out of here if I just do it ad lib. So we introduced our group, and we talked about Lou Laporta, and so one of the things that we wanted to talk about, something we're proud of, we presented a program we call Henderson Speaks, and we do that probably every other month throughout the year. And so far this past year, we presented a panel discussion, I think five different panel discussions, and some of them that I thought were noteworthy were, I had a panel discussion honoring former mayor Estes McDaniel, telling the history of the Three Kids Mine, the history of the old newspaper, the Henderson Home News, and told the history of the Henderson Library. We video record all of these panel discussions and then have them posted up on YouTube. So over the past 5 years, I'm sure we have 40-some, 50-some panel discussions. The speakers are old-time Henderson folks, people who can tell the history of Henderson. So one of the things we need to do is make sure that everybody knows how to find these resources. So great for people that are nostalgic about Henderson, but wonderful for teachers and for school kids. So that's part of why we're here. Go ahead, Sean.
Yeah, so you know, we're trying to grow these events as the Historical Society grows, and with that, that plays into the Henderson license plate, and that's kind of what we're here for. It's basically, you know, it's, you know, and we've all seen it. If you haven't, it has the people riding bikes in the mountains in the back, and essentially we have until, and the city has until the end of this year, of this calendar year, to sell 3,000 plates or else the plate will be discontinued. So what we're asking for is the help and the support of the council and the city staff and that to help promote and market this plate, because while we're the sponsor for the plate, it is the city's plate. If the plate goes away after, you know, after 2020, there's no City of Henderson license plate. So the proceeds for the plate, though, go to benefit the Historical Society. We do want to grow these events over time. We have a great lineup of events coming up. In fact, tomorrow night at Nevada State College, we have the history of the Henderson drag strip, which is a great story in itself. Just the photos alone from the presentation are going to be worthwhile to see. Anyway, we are hoping to grow these events. That takes money to do it. So we're hoping to get as much support as we can behind this license plate for this year, because like I said, it's, you know, use it or lose it. We have this year to do it. So any help, support that the city and staff can give us and the council, we greatly appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We obviously support that in any way we can. I personally have plate number 6. So I think that, we as a council are behind that, and we'll do what we can do to help support that. Thank you.
Next on your agenda is the city manager's report. I am pleased to announce that the City of Henderson has been named a Better Sports for Kids quality program provider for our youth sports programs. This designation demonstrates that we have shown a commitment to the children and families we serve and is a seal of our commitment to the nationally accepted standards for quality and safety. So congratulations to our Parks and Recreation Department. And that concludes the City Manager's Report.
Thank you.
Next section of your agenda is your consent agenda. Unless an item is pulled for discussion, council will take action on all consent agenda items with one motion, accepting the recommendations as stated on the agenda item. This evening, your consent agenda includes the items CA4 through CA22.
Anyone would like to pull an item? Seeing no one, I'll entertain a motion. There's a motion to approve. If you please vote. That motion carries.
As a reminder, UB23 has been continued, so that takes us to bills referred from committee for adoption as ordinance. O24 is bill number 3400, ZCA-201-900-4054-A1, Seven Hills, De La Vente Law Extensions. Your recommendation is adopted as ordinance number 3657.
Entertain a motion. A motion, if you'll please vote. The motion carries.
Next item is O25, bill number 3401, ZCA-201-900-3909, Alper Drive Apartments. Your recommendation is adopt as ordinance number 3658.
Entertain a motion. There's a motion, if you'll please vote. Motion carries.
Your next item is O26, bill number 3402, ZCA-201-900-4100, Executive Commercial Center. Recommendation, adopt is ordinance number 3659.
Thank you. I'll entertain a motion. Motion, if you'll please vote. That motion carries.
Next up, your agenda is new business. As a reminder, NB27 has been continued. That takes us to NB28, extension of board and commission member terms for Mayor Deborah March and Councilman John F. Mars appointments to various boards and committees. Your recommendation is approve the extension of terms to January 31st of 2023.
This is public hearing. Is there anyone like to meet, like to discuss this? Seeing no one, I'll close the public hearing. I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make the motion.
There's a motion, if you'll please vote. That motion carries.
Next agenda item is NB 29, extension of board and commission member terms for Councilwoman Michelle Romero and Councilman Dan K. Shaw and Dan H. Stewart appointments to various boards and commissions. Recommendation: approve the extension of terms to January 31st of 2025.
This is a public hearing. Is there anyone who would like to speak on this item? Seeing no one, close the public hearing and I'll entertain a motion. There's a motion. If you'll please vote. That motion carries.
The next item is NB 30, appointments, Mayor Deborah March, Charter Review Committee. Your recommendation, appoint James Martinez and John Simmons to the Charter Review Committee with terms to expire January 31st of 2023.
It's a public hearing. Anyone would like to make a comment on this? Seeing no one, I'll close the public hearing and I'll entertain a motion. There's a motion made. If you please vote. That motion carries.
Your next item is NB 31, appointment, Dan K. Shaw, Charter Review Committee. Recommendation, appoint Seton Curran and Aaron McMillan Midby to the Charter Review Committee with terms to expire January 31st of 2025.
This is a public hearing. If anyone would like to speak, please come forward. Seeing no one, I'll close the public hearing, and that would be my motion for approval. There's a motion. If you'll please vote.
I have to make the motion.
I made the motion. Oh, did. Sorry. That motion carries.
Next item is NB 32, appointment, Michelle Romero, Charter Review Committee. Recommendation is reappoint Lucila to the Charter Review Committee with a term to expire January 31st of 2025.
This is a public hearing. If anyone would like to speak on this matter, seeing no one, I'll close the public hearing. I'll entertain a motion. There's a motion. If you'll please vote. That motion carries.
Your next item is NB 33, appointment, Dan H. Stewart, Charter Review Committee. Your recommendation, reappoint Tina Past to the Charter Review Committee with term to expire January 31st of 2025.
This is a public hearing. If anyone would like to speak on this item, please come forward. Seeing no one, I'll close the public hearing. There's a motion. If you'll please vote. That motion carries.
Next item is NB 34, resolution providing notice of the intent to issue general obligation utility bonds and authorizing the publication of notice relating thereto. Your recommendation, adopt this resolution number 4375.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. For the record, Jim McIntosh, Chief Financial Officer. Before you is a resolution of the city's intent to issue $140 million in general obligation utility system bonds for water infrastructure projects and authorizing publication of a notice to inform the public of the city's intent. As part of this process, previously on January 9th, 2020, the city received its required approval from the Debt Management Commission to authorize the issuance of this debt. Staff recommends approval.
This is a public hearing. If anyone would like to speak on this matter, please come forward. Seeing no one, we will close the public hearing. I'll entertain a motion. There's a motion. If you'll please vote. That motion carries.
Next item is NB 35, a resolution providing notice of the intent to issue general obligation various purpose bonds and authorizing the publication of notice relating thereto. Your recommendation, adopt this resolution number 4376.
Mayor and Council, for the record, Jim McIntosh, Chief Financial Officer. Before you, similar to the previous item, is a resolution of the city's intent to issue $60 million in general obligation, various purpose bonds for building projects in the city and authorizing publication of a notice to inform the public of the city's intent. As part of this process, previously on January 9th, 2020, the city received its required approval from the Debt Management Commission to authorize the issuance of this debt. Staff recommends approval.
This is a public hearing. If anyone would like to speak on this matter, if you please come forward. Seeing no one, we'll close the public hearing. We'll entertain a motion. There's a motion. If you'll please vote. That motion carries.
Next item is NB 36, a resolution establishing a potential process and policy for appointments to vacant judicial offices. Your recommendation is adopt this resolution number 4377.
Mayor Pro Tem and Council, per Henderson City Charter Section 1.070 and HMC Section 2.08.030, upon the occurrence of a vacancy in the Office of Municipal Judge, the City Council may opt to appoint a qualified person to fill the vacancy within 60 days after the occurrence of the vacancy, or by resolution order a special election to be held no later than 90 days after the occurrence of the vacancy. This item establishes a process for filling a judicial vacancy through an appointment process should the council opt to do so.
Thank you. This is a public hearing. Is there anyone wishing to speak on this item? Seeing no one, will close the public hearing. We'll entertain a motion.
I'll make the motion.
There's a motion. If you'll please vote. That motion carries.
Next section agenda is bills we read in title. As a reminder, B37 was continued and B41 was withdrawn. Unless time is pulled for discussion, council will take action on all bills we read in title with one motion, referring the bills to the next city council committee meeting. B38 is accompanying bill number 3403 for CA20, annexation of 11.5 acres, Lake Mead Northeast. B39 is accompanying bill number 3404 for CA21, annexation of 15.5 acres, Lake Mead Northwest. B40 is accompanying bill number 3405 for CA22, annexation of 50 acres, Warm Springs South. The recommendation is refer B38 through B40 to committee meeting of February 4th, 2020.
Thank you. I'll entertain a motion for approval.
I'll make
it. Mid-motion. Motion, if you please vote. That motion carries. That brings us to mayor and council comments. Any comments? Seeing none, we'll set a meeting time for next meeting, what, 5:45? Okay. Public comment? Is there anyone would like to make a public comment? Seeing no one, the meeting will stand adjourned. Thank you.
Good job, man.